everyone. Welcome to the class. But it's not about class, of course. I'm going to show you how to accompany songs on the keyboard or using keyboard. I think for some of you, playing keyboard is very easy. And I guess some of you might feel a little challenged. So I'll just show you how to accompany songs with really, really basic accompaniment. And it really relates to the guitar strumming we learned. Somehow it's really closely connected. It's because it's all about how to express rhythm on the and press the harmony. But I think in terms of accompaniment, rhythm comes first before harmony. Anyway, so I will use all the song materials we used so far, and then I will explain how to accompany these songs on the keyboard. Okay, so C or C. How's it? If you think it's simple, it is. If you think it's too difficult, it may be. However, if you remember to practice major chord progressions again, like guitar, C, F, G7, D, G, A7. You know? G. Chord. You can start, you can even start doing like hello everyone when you really start first if you are a beginner in keyboard. Hello everyone, hello everyone, it's nice to see you here. So it's just 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's easy this way. And some songs is useful doing this. So it's good to, you know, learn chords, block chords. If you want to do bass down, bass down. Do you remember we learned on the guitar bass down for double meters? So. With your left hand, press C, and then right hand, play the blocked C chord. If it's G, F, 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 G. If it is just bass down, just hello everyone, hello everyone, bass down, hello. another chord. For example, Inchy Winchy Spider. Inchy Winchy Spider, climb up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed poor Inchy out. Up came the sunshine and drive up all the rain. Inchy Winchy Spider, climb up the spout again. So, you know, the 10 songs for children, all the children's songs, it is written based on the C chord. It's all, you know, comprised of C, G, F, G7. So if you are new to keyboard, just learn C, G, F, G7, and just keep practicing, just focus on this. So if it's bass down, just basically C, left hand, just C, C, A, oh, A, F, G, G, C, C, G, G7, G7. If you want to have an alternate bass, it's just your left bass note alternates either C and G. So what about this? So I'm gonna shake my sleeves out. So basically, if you can play the block, you can even do this. I'm gonna shake, shake, shake. I think that's enough so we call it, when you play guitar, I call it bass down. On the keyboard, I'll call it boom chop, boom chop, boom chop, boom chop. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in. Let's move on to boom chok chok. What is it? It's triple meters. It's like bass down down. When you play something triple meter or waltz, we'll play boom chok chok, boom chok chok. And on the guitar guide 4, when I picked 10 songs for adults, older adults, we did lots of triple meters. So, for example, so chop chop. All of the songs we learned for old idols, you can use boom chop chop. So okay, so I think it's very clear about boom chok, boom chok, and then boom chok chok, boom chok chok, right? We also learned arpeggios, and the last, the 10 songs for arpeggio finger picking will come under this. So again, it's all chord blocks, and you either play one of the chords or bass chord or press everything together, or in terms of arpeggios you can play each note one by one. So for example, we learned bass 3-2-1, so that is like bass 3-2-1, bass 3-2-1. I'll be playing over the rainbow. About if I play it's hard to find the one with the bass 3-2-1. I think bass 3-2-1-2-3 is much, we'll use much more than bass 3-2-1. Bass 3-2-1-2-3 is much more useful. Anyway, so bass 3-2-1. Five little dots. That works fantastic with this double meter. Okay, we'll play five little dots. So C, 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 E, G, F. Mother ducks said, Okay, so this works well. Five little dots. What about? So it works for Old MacDonald. What about? For all the doppelmitters. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. So bass 3-2-1 is like bass. Bass 3-2-1. Yeah? Okay, let's move on to bass 3-2-1-2-3. That works with all the triplets. I think so. Or try, let's try. For all the songs we learned, like What a Wonderful World. I see trees are green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, oh, what a wonderful. It's all based on chords, yeah? Just learn the chords and learn the inner patterns. Then you'll be fine. Okay, I wanted to demonstrate Hey Jude because it's a variation of bass 3-2-1. So bass. Hey Jude, don't make it bad. So bass 3-2-1 works with this Hey Jude, but if you can, you can even do bass 3 and then play together the, you know, is it obvious? So G chord, I play just the bass G, and then with the right hand I play B and then D and G together. can keep going that way. You can practice that way. Another one worthwhile to practice is read some music. So when you come to the proficiency exam, you are supposed to sight read. And when you come to sight reading, you are given some music like this. Yeah, and you will have to read the music as it is, or you should be able to play the chord accompaniment and sing. So either way is fine, but you should be able to read, sight read, and then sing the song, practicing sight reading as well. So for example, this is called Clementine. So this might be on your exam. I will maybe show it to you. I showed you how to accompany songs with basic patterns. Boom chok, boom chok, boom chok chok, boom chok chok. Bass 3-2-1, bass 3-2-1, bass 3-2-1-2-3, bass 3-2-1-2-3. Sure. So if you are not confident with all of this, you better start now. Memorize all the chords and, you know, practice all the patterns. And if you can, learn to sight read, Even if you can read the melody at the spot, and if you just can accompany yourself using chords, that is still fine. If you have any question, you can email me. Hello! So we've learned basic accompaniment patterns, strumming patterns, and finger picking patterns on the guitar. Also, I briefly showed you how to accompany songs with keyboard. I'm going to show you two more instruments that you can use for your recreative method. So obviously, ukulele would be very useful. And I'm not sure how many of you are familiar or can play uke very well. I'm sure some of you are very good, some of you never touched, some of you have it but never really practiced. But I think, you know, it's a really, really good instrument that you can learn apart from guitar and keyboard. And it's really easy. So I'll just give you a brief introduction and show you how to play. So, you know, you don't have to start practicing, but still it goes to your mind, and then when you have some time, you can pull it off maybe easily. So this is soprano, tenor, ukulele. There are different types, like baritone ukulele, tenor ukulele, However, I am using soprano, concert, and tenor ukulele, and then it has like G, C, E, A. Tuning goes like G, C, E, A, right? And then, you know, there are basic ukulele chords that I'm going to share with you. But it's quite easy once you master guitar. It's easy, so I'm going to share this, but I'll just show you C, key of C. So C, this is C. So your fourth finger of the left hand goes on the bottom string, and then third fret, C. Songs you can play now, because you've got the chords, you got the lyrics, you know how to sing. So I think I demonstrated all most songs on the guitar and the keyboard. What about, yeah, so for example, I play Baba Black Sheep. To use a pick. Do I have a pick somewhere? I do not have a pick. Oh, here we go. It's just here. Okay, so what about Old MacDonald? Old MacDonald?
you can play everything. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, then you really are showing. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, then you really ought to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. So you can play all of your children's songs on the uke. I can imagine you using uke with children, it's light, and if they want to strum, it's much softer and lighter than the guitar, so it would be great. And they can learn just pressing one or two. Smaller, they can handle it easily than guitar. Okay, so yeah, uke, think about it. Okay, now the next one I want to introduce is Q-Chord. Have you seen this before? It's called Q-Chord. I think we have. Auto-Harp, we have Auto-Harp. It's quite similar like Auto-Harp, so this is Auto-Harp. Maybe we need to tune or something, but see? I think I need a stronger pick. That's why the sound is not really good, but I just need stronger pick. Basically, there are lots of chords and you need to strum and sing. But this is a bit heavy and it's a bit tougher to play these strings. So we think Q chord is much lighter and easier. It's a little bit similar, but here we go. Here is the power. So you see the lights come. Okay, I'll do it again. So, power on, lights on. So here we go. There's all the chords, major chords. So major chord, C, G, D, A, E, B, F sharp, or the other. And then minor, sevenths. Basically, under C, you can have C major chord, C minor chord, C7 chord. So if I play start here, C, C minor, C7, and then G, and then G minor. 7. if you see here, it says rhythms. So it's got bossa nova, country, dance, jazz, new age, march, waltz, ballad, rock, blues, shuffle. So you just need to, here is, we have a button for volume and tempo, and you, these are buttons to select which rhythm you want. And here we go, intro, fill, end. So for example, if we want to do a waltz and then C, we go, if it's too fast, and I will make volume up. Volume, this is volume, master volume. What does it say? Strum plate voices. So again, here we go. We have like guitar, piano, strings, vibes, what is it? Organ, voice, flute, harp, synth, sound effects. So what about I play harp? Oh, here we go. Harp, I selected harp. And if I go, maybe I sell it. Maybe, yeah. Oh. Oh. Ah. Shuffle your hands, you can make the sound, extra sounds. So this will give you harmony and this will give some rhythm and it's extra sounds. What else? Oh, if you press melody keyboard, here we go, you can play this like keyboard, you know, not both sense, but then just melody. Okay, so I will demonstrate some songs on the Q chord. So in the Q chord, mainly you can work, when you work with old adults, you can use. I will try, I thought I Have a Dream sounded good. So we can try I Have a Dream on the Q chord. Or even Kesarasara, we can try Kesarasara. I think that might be even better. So Kesarasara. By the way, if you are not confident with F chord, you can just press the button. So this one, because Kesarasara is like waltz, so I'll play waltz. And then have a listen. strings. Okay. So that's D, G7. How you use Q chord. It takes some time to, you know, be familiar with the chord progressions and then manipulate all this, but I'm sure you will be alright.
See you.
Yes, that's it. Do you like it? How do you like it? There are more functions, like a pitch bend. Yeah, more functions. So you can imagine your clients, you know, playing with this beat, playing with this beat. Yeah. And also, I will maybe show you how to play melody keyboard. Yeah, I think so. So it goes like. So you can think about people making maybe improvisation with the button. When you play, you know, on the keyboard or guitar, when you support, your clients can make music with these easily, and then, you know, sing together, recreate songs together, but also it'll be great for improvisation or even songwriting. Yeah, it's easy. So these are additional instruments you may be able to practice and use in your practice in the future. But of course, try to focus more on the guitar and keyboard at this time, so you know you are confident to pass the proficiency exams. But if you feel like you are very confident to pass those instruments, yeah, it's a good option. We also have Reverie Harp in our music department. We learned receptive method. When you have to create something live, relaxing, this could be an option too. Wanted to show you everything I have in my room at the moment. Okay, thank you. And bye. Bye.